And many of us walk when we think about the loom light in today's world. Clearly, you can see what it has done to the thousands of us who are still on this earth. But if it provides some kind of assistance, help, relief of suffering, then I cannot, in good conscience, be opposed.
Brenner, who saw thalidomide's curative powers firsthand after being prescribed it for a deadly skin disease, says that the drug's circuitous history tells us a great deal about the accidental nature of drug discovery.
It's kind of surprising, I think, to most people to learn that drugs are, in fact, developed and then become, as they're called, a drug in search of a disease.
But for all its benefits, the scientific rehabilitation of thalidomide has come with a heavy cost. We were told this could never happen again. In Brazil, where the drug is used extensively to treat leprosy, researchers have documented that new thalidomide children have been born.
Alan, who's 8, has been terribly damaged by thalidomide, which his mother took by accident when she was pregnant.
50 years down the road, I would like to think that there's no such thing as thalidomide. That we have created something, and we have developed something that would allow us to bury thalidomide. Literally. Destroy it. Get rid of it. So that there are no further discussions other than a note in history.